Full details of those are set out in the exempt appendix with some performance numbers. I won't dwell on the performance numbers, they're good, but it's too early really to say that this is going to continue in the future. So happy to take any questions on that. But members are asked to note the report and approve the recommendation to give delegated authority to officers to increase the allocation to GEAL by a further 2%, subject to them being satisfied with regard to the investment and operational needs of the fund. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Peter. Any comments? Or okay. So, new members of the fund, I'd just like to, if you read through the appendix, items where it talks about the investments, it's you know, the fact that you, as you drive up to Glasgow, you see your the Clyde wind farm that we partly own, and it's very impressive really some of the investments that we do have, and I'd just like to commend the work that our officers do in building this fund for us, from which our pensioners are able to benefit. So thank you for that, Peter.
Sorry. Just about the aerobic digester that we will get. Where is that up to? Is that going to be involved in this general thing? Or is that separate, just exclusively to us?
Well, I'm happy to comment on that in as much as because we were the first pension fund to invest in Iona Capital, we've invested in a number of aerobic digestion plants throughout the UK. I was able to go to North Yorkshire to be involved in the opening of one that we paid for and invested in. And it would seem sensible that we have one here on the Wirral to be able to recycle our own food waste. There is a cost to that to Wirral Council for collection, and there's no money in the pot for that at the moment, but we are holding an event on the 18th of September, and that is a green investment event, which is a new date. And the purpose of that is to try and get food waste producers on the Wirral to make a commitment to help us move this project forward. Merseyside Pension Fund are committed to providing finance for it, but there is an operational cost to that which needs to be considered. So, certainly as chair of the fund, I'm very pushy. As some of you will know, I am Councillor Paul, not Doughty, not Stephen Doughty MP, those who look at Wirral Globe. But, you know, I'm certainly pushing to try and move it forward, and hopefully we as members of this committee can help support that event. Does that answer your question?
That's fine.
Yeah, thank you. So thanks for that. Any other questions on? Okay. Right, that's excellent. So we have working party minutes from our meetings that if we're happy to approve. They're in the exempt items of tonight's meeting, but other than that. Sorry, getting ahead of myself. So yeah, Peter's going to talk us through our pooling update. Sorry.
The pooling update is a standing item on the agenda to provide members with an update on where we are in pooling with our two pooling partners, West Yorkshire and Greater Manchester Pension Funds. Under Section 2, there are a number of appendices attached to this report. Appendices 1 and 2 provide members with copies of the report provided to MHCLG. Appendix 3 provide members of minutes of a shadow job committee on the 24th of April. And then finally, we had a meeting with the Minister on the 23rd of May, following which we provided some further information to him and to MHCLG, which are provided at appendices 4 and 5. Pooling is a significant undertaking. It will result in changes to the oversight and management of LGPS assets, and it's important that appropriate governance is in place. That will be subject, any governance arrangements will be subject to full council, and obviously we'll go through legal services team before anything is brought over to this committee and then to full council. But that's it, Chair. Happy to answer any questions.
Okay, the pooling is obviously a big you know, issue. It takes up a lot of our officers' time at the moment. But we do have a good working relationship with our pooling partners, West Yorkshire Pension Fund, Greater Manchester pension fund. In fact, I'm going to the to West Yorkshire's pensions committee meeting on the 26th to see what they do and what they don't do, and also at Manchester to see if we can pick up any ways forward. But we have a very good working relationship with them. I'm pleased to be able to say I think everything's going in the right direction. And when we met with the pensions minister in London to discuss the Northern Pool, he was very impressed with the work that's been done so far, particularly with our infrastructure investment and GLIL and what we do there. So it was very positive. So thank you for all the work that you've done. And we're happy to note the recommendations there in the report. And again, as I was moving forward before, happy to note the minutes in item 18, approve the minutes as in the exempt item. Okay, so on that basis, I'm just happy to move to the exempt item in tonight's agenda, and under section 100A4 of the Local Government Act 1972, the public be excluded from meeting during consideration of the following items of business on the grounds that they involve the election disclosure of exempt information as defined by the relevant paragraphs, Part 1 of Schedule 12A as amended to the Act, and the public interest test has been applied and favours exclusion. So, we're happy to propose that.
Second.
Thank you. We'd like to thank the members of the public for their attendance at tonight's meeting.